In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a 3D logo with custom textures using the Element 3D plugin in After Effects. Hope you enjoyed the tutorial and let's get to it. First, I'll create a new composition, name it Render. It will be in 1920 by 1080, 30 frames per second, 10 seconds for the duration. Then open 3D Renderer tab and make sure the renderer is set to Classic 3D, then click OK. Now drag the logo to the timeline. Press S on the keyboard to adjust the scale if needed. I'll decrease mine a bit. Now, right-click the logo, select Precompose, let's name this Precomp Logo, and make sure the Move attribute is selected, then click OK. Now, while the logo comp is highlighted, let's go up here to Layer, and then select Auto Trace. And these are the settings that I'm using to trace the outlines of the logo, and make sure the Apply to a New Layer is not checked, then click OK. At this point, you can hide the composition from here, and create a new solid. So, Layer, New Solid. Let's name this one Element. Then go to Effects and Presets and search for Element, then apply to the solid. Now we need the effect controls here. The first thing you want to do is open the custom layers, custom text and masks. And for the path layer 1, we're going to select the logo. And that's it. Let's collapse it and click the scene setup button. So once the Element 3D interface shows up, first thing you want to do is click the extrude button. And now you should see the shape of your logo appear. Let's make it a bit thicker or give it more depth. The way we do that is first expand the extrusion module here. Select bevel 1. Here in the bevel settings, let's set extrude to a higher value, to maybe 3. And you can see that works. Now let's scroll down to the texture settings. And the one we need is normal bump. So click the none set button for the normal bump. Then click the load texture. Now navigate to wherever your textures are saved. So I've included two different bump maps in the project files. You're free to use those. Or if you have your own textures, again, you're free to use them as well. So I'm going to navigate to wherever mine are. And here is the bump map number 1. This one is for the logo. I'm simply going to select it, click open. And then you can see the texture has been applied. But I'm going to set UV repeat to 2x2 just to make that texture a bit smaller. And then simply click OK. Now I'm going to scroll down to the reflectivity. Or to the basic settings at diffuse color, and this is like to change the color of the logo. So I'll set it to a very light blue, something like this, just to give it a slight tint of blue. Click OK. Then for the reflectivity, I'm going to set intensity to 50%, just to get these nice reflections in the logo. And let's also add or select the environment. So click on presets, environment. I'll be using the basic ones here. You have 15 different ones available. I'm going to select the first one, the basic 2K01, and I'll add an environment, as you can see. Now let's add a new plane. So create new plane, and this will be our floor. So I'm going to set the size of it to 20 by 20. Make sure you check the option for two-sided plane so you can see from both sides. Now let's set the orientation of it to 90 degrees. And we're going to move the plane back behind our logo on the Z-axis. Just simply drag it back like that. And now we are going to apply the texture to it. So here, if you have the pro shaders available, you can use some kind of like a metal texture and that should work fine. But in case if you don't have those, you can use the texture that I've provided in the project file. So first, go into the physical, add metal diffused to the plane model, then expand the properties and select the metal diffused here and go to the textures. And again, click on the node set for the normal bump, load textures. And again, select the second texture that I've provided, this one. Click OK. And I'm going to set the amount to 25% so that those bumps are not too intense. Then click OK. And since we've set the plane size to be 20 by 20, which is really high, you can see that the texture is getting stretched and loses a lot of quality. So the way to fix that is we need to select the plane model here, not the metal diffuse, but the plane model. Let's find the UV mapping settings and set UV repeat to a high value, to maybe 8x8. And you could see that increases the quality, or well, pretty much what that does, it tiles the texture instead of stretching it. So now it looks a lot better. So that works. Now let's select the metal diffused again. Let's scroll down to the reflectivity and I'm going to change the color to a bit gray like this. Then click OK. I'm also going to right-click on the plane model, go to reflect mode and select the mirror surface. Nothing's going to happen, but once we change the lighting, it will in the main composition. And after doing all that, I think we're done here, so click OK. And this is our logo in the composition. First, let's create a camera. So layer a new camera, 35mm preset, click OK. Now I'm going to select the camera orbital, then hold the Alt key, right mouse button to zoom in, left mouse button to orbit, and the mouse wheel to pan the camera around. So use those shortcuts while working with the camera. So I'll simply find an angle that I like, something like this, and that works. Let's switch back to the selection tool. I'm going to select the element here, and in effect controls, first let's open the group one settings, particle replicator, rotation, and let's place the time indicator at the start of the timeline. I'm going to use the Z rotation, so I'll create a keyframe and set it to negative 20 degrees. Then let's go to 5 seconds and set it to 20 degrees. And now that will simply rotate the scene, and that looks nice. Now let's open the render settings, then physical environment, rotate environment, and I'm going to rotate the environment in such a way that we get very light reflections, the bright reflections on the logo. So play around with the environment. So maybe 75 degrees should do. You can see that nice, we'll get these nice reflections. And now again, at the start of the timeline, I'm going to create keyframe for Z rotation for the environment. Go to 5 seconds. And I'll simply set it to maybe 10 degrees just to create slight movement in the environment. Now I'm going to open the lighting settings. For the add lighting, I'll add an aqua light. And as we do that, you can see that we are getting this nice lighting and even a bit of like reflection on the floor. And we're going to fix the look of it in just a bit. So scroll down to the ambient occlusion. Let's enable the AO, then set intensity to 10 to get these nice shadows. And after doing all that, we can select the element layer here, go into edit, duplicate, or press Ctrl D as a shortcut. And I'm going to rename the duplicate to AO. Make sure it is highlighted, then in effect control, scroll all the way down to the output settings. And then for that show, we're going to set it to ambient occlusion. And now we need this mode colon. So click toggle switches and modes until you do. And set the AO's mode to multiply. And as we do that, that adds an extra layer of AO or the ambient occlusion. Now all there is left is to animate the camera. But since we've added the rotation to the scene throughout the composition, I'm not going to animate the camera for the first 2.5 seconds, but what I do instead is I'll move the time indicator to 2 seconds 15 frames. I'll select the camera, then go up to edit and select split layer to split the camera. Then I'll make sure you're selecting the camera to select the camera orbital, and let's change up the angle. So maybe like a close-up top-down view like that. Place it like this. Then expand the settings of the camera to transform and create keyframes for point of view and interest. Then let's go to 5 seconds. I'm going to move the camera across to the top right and create this panning. And that's the camera angle we're getting here. Now the last thing we need is to add the depth of field. So let's expand the properties of the first camera, camera options. Let's enable depth of field. I'm going to set aperture to 100 and blur level to 150. And here we need to control the focus distance. So easiest way to do that is to set it, set the view to 2 views. And now let's decrease the focus distance. And you can see that this part is the focus distance. So let's keep decreasing it until, like, you can see it touches the logo here. And now camera is focusing on this part. And, you know, this part is out of focus. So let's set the focus distance to 800. And that looks very good. Now, let's select the other camera and do the same thing. So, expand the properties, camera options, enable depth of field, aperture 100, blur level 150. And again, let's move the time indicator forward in time. And now let's decrease the focus distance. Again, let's set it to 800. And that looks very nice. So, let's leave it at 800. Now, go back to the one view and we can preview this from the beginning. And here's a preview of our logo animation. I think it turned out pretty nice. What do you guys think? And that is it for today. I hope you enjoyed and learned something new in this tutorial. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace out.